Hello and welcome to another CF PowerScript tutorial with me, Christian Rauchenwald. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the CF user data PowerScript to add personalized data or personalized information to your funnels. Now, in order to get started, you need to go to your CF PowerScript's dashboard and navigate to the PowerScript section. Select the funnel where you want to use the PowerScript, which in my case is going to be our members area 2.0 share funnel, and select the funnel step where you want to add it, which in my case is the membership area. Now, as you can see, I've already added the user data script, so I'm simply going to remove it. And when we go to the membership area, right now it says, welcome Christian to CF members area 2.0. Once I refresh the page, you will see that it says, welcome name to CF members area 2.0. So that's the variable we are using here to actually write the user's first name. Now, the moment we add that PowerScript by clicking add new and selecting the CF user data PowerScript by clicking on it, and simply clicking add script since there are no settings, we can see when we refresh the same members area that it suddenly shows my name here again. And if I change to another lesson and I change back, it still stays here. Now, you can use that PowerScript on any funnel step or page, even globally, and add it to all of your funnels. However, it's crucial that you understand how it works. The PowerScript has only access to the information that the user already provided before. So in order to show the name here, the user previously has to submit any kind of form that asks him for his name. Beyond that, there are two limitations that apply. Number one, the name of the user is always stored per domain. So if you have an application funnel on myapplication.com where you ask for the name, but your membership area is on mymembershiparea.com, it will not work because on mymembershiparea.com, the name was never captured. Additionally, if the name is not set, the variable simply gets removed. So if I didn't provide my name on a previous step before, instead of welcome name to CF members area 2.0, it would simply say welcome to CF members area 2.0. So you need to consider that when you create the content and when you use those variables, that in the case where the variable doesn't have a specific value, it will simply be empty and removed from the text so that the text still is nicely readable even without the variable. Now, that's pretty much it. That's how easy you can add the CF user data PowerScript to your funnels to personalize your user's experience. As always, if you have any questions whatsoever, make sure to check out our FAQ. And if you cannot find the answer there, either use our contact form to reach out to us or ask within our CF PowerScript's Facebook group. Or if you're a member of our VIP plan, then ask within our Slack channel and the live chat in there. As always, thanks for watching, and even more so, thanks for using CF PowerScript. See you in one of our other videos. Till then, bye-bye.